they started bone marrow transplantation in CMC Vellore in the year 1986. First stem cell transplant done in Vellore in 1986. Today in India there are about 53 transplant centers, and they all meet at Vellore once a year for a meeting which is called the Indian Stem Cell Transplant Registry. And last year we have recorded 1,600 transplants done all over this country. So India is slowly increasing the number of centers which can do transplants and the number of transplants which are being done. When I was in Vellore in 2008, we had a patient from Muscat who had acute myeloid leukemia. He had relapsed, and this is an Indian patient who was, and he needed a transplant. He had no sibling donors. India had not done a single matched unrelated transplant before that. So we approached the National Marrow Donor Registry in the United States. We got a donor who was fully matching. He never had the money, but all his friends and colleagues, who were all IT people all over the world, they told his wife, "You don't worry, there'll be money in your bank account. Whatever expense has to be given, we will find the money." So the patient actually had the first matched unrelated stem cell transplant in India. Cells came all the way from the United States and carried, and the transplant was done in Vellore. I visited him in Dubai last year, 8 years after transplant. He is a computer engineer. His two sons, who were tiny at the time that he was transplanted, are now young boys, and he's leading a full life, doing everything that he would not have been able to do otherwise. And I think that is an example of what can be done with a matched unrelated stem cell transplant. So this program, till now, we were not having an Indian registry. So the only people we could go to was outside this country. Despite having 1.2 billion people, we didn't have a registry of donors. Whereas around the world today, there are more than 25 billion people who are willing to donate stem cells, who are registered with their national organizations, one of the largest being the National Marrow Donor Program of the United States. In UK, the Anthony Nolan Registry. Anthony was a young boy with leukemia who couldn't have a transplant because he didn't have a donor. He died, and his mother gave millions of pounds to start the registry in England. In Germany, the weekend. Like that, almost every country in the world has a national registry and a program to enlist donors, and these donors can be searched anywhere in the world. So there is an association called Bone Marrow Donors Worldwide, BMDW, and the data of these 25-26 million people, their HLA typing, is available on the net for searching by people who are authorized to do this search. So we are very happy that India now has a registry, and you are already told there are 175 were 185,000 donors registered with Daktri. And the nice thing is that all these donors are high resolution type, which means that we can quickly find out whether the match is in fact perfect with your own patient if you do the high resolution typing for your patient. And therefore, the information comes to us very, very quickly. Within 2 to 3 days, we know yes, there is a donor who is available for your patient. So, I believe that matched stem cell transplantation is certainly a way to go for a person who needs a transplant, does not have a sibling donor with a match, and it can be a life-saving treatment. And we are happy that more and more people in India are willing to become donors. While I was sitting with the reporter, she asked me what is the risk of donating stem cells, right? So I asked her, what is the risk of crossing the street in front of Tata Medical Center in Kolkata? Actually, it's quite high, you know, because the cars come at a fantastic speed, thinking that the lights at the next corner will never come back green again if they become red. Right? So, weird mentality, you know. But I would say a stem cell donation is much, much less than the risk of being hit by a car outside Tata Medical Center. So it's essentially a safe procedure. In Bangalore, when I was there, we had completed 600 transplants, and by God's grace, not a single problem with a donor who was willing to donate, either by bone marrow harvest or by peripheral blood stem cell harvest. So it's an extremely safe procedure, and therefore I think people worry, will there be any, if you donate a kidney, yes, you've lost the kidney. But if you donate stem cells, you really lost nothing, because within a day or two, your bone marrow will make up those stem cells. So there is no permanent, long-term consequence of donating stem cells for a bone marrow transplant. So I am not going to say anything about our patient. You want me to? No, you'll do that later. So with these words, I would like to thank Daktri, thank the donors who are willing to donate stem cells, and thank the patient, because really a patient has to trust his doctor a lot, that to say yes, I believe what you're saying is correct, and that you are only going to do what is the best possible for me to save my life. So that trust is something which is terribly important. If the patient has even the slightest doubt that the doctor is really not going to suggest what's best for me, then we are in a lot of difficulty. So I'm actually quite amazed that families and patients are willing to put their trust in the doctor and the medical system which handles him, and thereby achieve a cure. Thank you.